Find yourself in the Beachview area of Pittsburgh? Check out the official pizza of this show, Slice on Broadway, sharing an abnormal obsession with pizza we can relate to. Check them out at sliceonbroadway.com and tell them this show sent you.
I'm hungry, spark, but I ain't starving yet. Chain for the pain, cocktail for the set. Never said I was a gangster or thug, but I'm an animal. Peanut for the taste of the poor.
Guys, it is the Indy Mayhem Show. This is episode 100, and I will caution you, I'm a little drunk because we just did a 500 episode of Wrestling Mayhem Show. We're going to have a lot of fun. I'm Mike Sorg, at Sorgatron on the Twitters, and video production person here with the International Wrestling Cartel, Renegade Wrestling Alliance, and a lot of other things like Finding Zach Gallen, Montreal Theory, and that thing with Virgil. IndieWrestling.us. With me, as usual, is my buddy from San Antonio, Texas. He is Eamon. He is the voice of Inspire Pro Wrestling down there. How you doing, sir?
We did it, Sorg.
We made a 100. We made a triple digits.
We done did it. It is our 100th episode.
We're 100th episode. And while we had something special for 50, we have something even more special. It's a party. It is a party atmosphere here in Pittsburgh, PA, in the Mayhem Studios. Check out all the rest of the stuff at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. And I'll spare you the rest of the details. Follow that. Thanks, Basic Sickness. And we'll move on. But in here, in the studio, with us tonight is a collection of the most interesting people that I know in professional wrestling. Is that fair? Does that sound fair?
No.
That's all right.
First of all, a longtime veteran of the Mayhem Show, returning to the Indy Mayhem Show. Not many people do that. I'll be fair. Not many people have come back. I don't know if that's by choice or because of our booking practices.
This STD always comes back.
This STD, he is the leader of the sexy, talented dudes.
No, we're all equal.
This is an equal partnership? Okay. He is Chest Flexor.
I am.
You are.
Don't worry. I've plenty for you. Go around.
All right. Also with us, he is the bowler, Bryan McDowell.
Strike, baby.
And I have a beer that
all the time. Good. Drink your beer. Bowling and beer.
We can. By the way, one of the guys that was on earlier for Awesome Cast, he is a beer fellow. ShouldIDrinkThat.com. That's his podcast. Tell me, what am I drinking right now? Because I can't read it because I've already been drinking.
Strawberry Lancaster wheat.
Recommended by El Jefe.
By El Jefe. Yes. Oh, I know him from the IWC board. That's right. El Jefe, thank you for the recommendation. Strawberry wheat. It's delicious. I like things that are very hoppy. Very well. Also with us over in the Mayhem set. By the way, shout-outs. If you guys didn't listen to Wrestling Mayhem Show 1, I'm sorry if you did. But right behind Lee Evans there is the great Mayhem Show tree by Jen Carlin. So first props for that if you're on video. It's glorious. Isn't that thing awesome? Like, that is some crafty work right there by Jen Carlin.
It's awful. It's terrible.
Corey, they don't have Christmas trees in the future. Corey Futuristic joining us there.
Hello.
I don't know. Maybe move that a little. I don't know. Maybe a little closer to the mic. I don't know what's going on over there. We'll work on that as we go here. There we go. Hello.
Make sure you can hear
Hello
Corey.
Hello
there. There he is. Corey Futuristic joining us, as well as Lee Evans.
No,
you son of a bitch.
Gary Larry.
Son of a bitch.
Listen, I'm about halfway.
Whatever.
I'm about halfway through this thing. I don't know.
He's at every show, and he's still
Lee Evans. Who is he? Is he a Tampa Bay Buccaneers wide receiver? I do believe.
His name is Andrew Palace. What?
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 Lee Ryan's joining us as well, and off, pop your head in there. The Rizz.
Put your arm around him.
I thought that was Andrew Palace.
No, he's not part of the STDs, although he might be after
That's
tonight.
Probably
I don't
what
know.
Andrew would look like if he cut his hair. Probably just like Rizz.
Like Rizz? Okay. All right. So, like I said, this is going to be a little bit different. It is a celebration. We just celebrated Wrestling Mayhem Show 500. This is the 100th episode of Indy Mayhem Show. So we have the STDs, the sexy, talented dudes. I figured that would take care of itself. Tonight, but Chest Flexor, how are you doing?
You know, I was doing great at 11.
At 11,
all hyped up, ready to go.
okay.
And then you know,
we were booked at 11.
You were booked
just
at
kept
11.
On going on.
I warned you. It might be a little weird.
Can we
tonight.
Just get right to the point? Let's
what is
start it off?
Right.
We have gifts.
You have gifts.
Gifts for you, for whoever.
This is a first for the Indy Mayhem Show. I've never received gifts on the Mayhem Show.
Aww, well, do you remember? I want to ask you a question. Do you remember the very first time I came on the Wrestling Mayhem Show?
You,
I brought gifts.
You did?
I brought.
He doesn't remember.
Test tubes.
Oh.
Filled with stuff.
Something. Yeah.
Something.
I was. It wasn't it like pump juice? Is that what you call it? Because Pump Ferrari was your partner in crime at the
where
time.
Where are those test tubes?
Where is Pump Ferrari?
He's actually closer than you think.
You guys scary. Didn't do something with
was he in those test tubes?
Light tubes, did you?
What's that?
Did you do something with a mouse with those light tubes? That
test
he,
tubes.
Test tubes? What?
Test tubes. The tubes of the test.
Right. Yeah. Oh, okay. So this is a history.
And this is the future.
How many years ago is this? What are we talking?
It was... couple hundred episodes.
I can I can find out.
Pull up the episode.
Let's see. We do have the Google machine, which apparently. Oh no!
There
I
you go.
Oh,
don't drop your beer, Sorg. Do not waste the alcohol, please.
It's just fine.
Very
it's
important.
Just fine.
Do not.
I'm gonna make a
alcohol.
Guess. It was episode 17.
17.
That's my guess.
You think so?
First of all, have you told these other three STDs the rules?
There's rules.
Of the Mayhem Show.
There's rules.
I don't know. Why don't you share with them the
I
rules of the Mayhem Show?
I was gonna take off my shirt.
Well, that's good thing you said that. Because the rules are, every time someone says a swear word, curse word, you have to take off an article of clothing. Every time,
oh, so,
every time
well,
someone.
So that's what happened last time you were on.
Every time someone stutters, you have to stick your finger in the orifice of someone sitting to the left of you.
Oh no.
I fucking hate you.
Sorry. Sorry.
And the third and most important rule is if you don't leave this building, this structure, with an item that you found in it, then you're never coming back.
Wait a minute.
Wait, we get this.
I was going to say, there's this Hulk pain train going on right now. I want to steal that right away.
I have
away.
Some S video cores I can give
I
you on your way out. I mean,
no,
I,
that's not taking. That's receiving.
No, that's receiving. Okay.
And I don't.
Those are three generations of figurines.
I don't receive.
The Hogans are not up for the taking. I got it. The Hogan human centipede that's happening before you on the center table is not.
Has it ever been showcased before on your show?
They were part of the Awesome Cast.
Okay, good.
They were not in that fashion, but very close to.
So tell me what the Awesome Cast is. I don't even know.
The Awesome Cast is a technology podcast where we talk about technology from people who are using it in Pittsburgh, PA,
okay.
A lot of startups, stuff like that.
Probably listen to it. I am in the IT field, so I should probably.
I thought you were a bowler.
Yeah, I thought you were a bowler.
Oh, I bowl every day. I bowl every day.
You bowl every day.
He told us he left us for a year for bowling, and now we're finding out he's doing IT tech college stuff.
Are you asking me how many fingers I put in holes?
Why? I think that's accurate.
Okay. What? Well, I put three fingers in a ball every day of my life. I bowl 300s all the time.
Throw 300s. He can't bowl more than 300.
I've been in tournaments. I was in tournaments.
That is perfection.
I think
perfection.
On the next time we're here, we need to have him prove it and have a video like Mr. Perfect where he's bowling a 300.
We can do
I never went bowling with Bryan. I invite him bowling all the time. Yeah.
I can see it. Bryan, we need to have a bowling outing.
Evidence.
I don't know if you know this. I think you're aware of this. We had discussions early on.
Yes.
And I was a bowler.
Okay.
In my heart, I'm still a bowler.
Played for a league?
I was part of a league.
Excellent.
I was part of a league. Much through my high school years. I was part, not a high school league or anything.
Did you ever get
the
ring for the 300?
I never got the 300. The highest I got was probably a 270.
That's not bad, Sorg. Yeah. I mean, I can teach you.
I did that at a tournament in DuBois, PA.
Okay.
We listened to Polka on the way.
So what you're saying is we need to go on location to like Latitude 40 or whatever, some sort of gimmick that has a bowling alley in it. And you and the Kingpin, Lord of the Lanes, will duke it out.
Is this a challenge?
I'd buy it.
Three fingers in the holes.
Three fingers.
Three fingers.
Make a
two.
Make a Facebook event.
I usually use four fingers.
Make them
better. In the future, they use four fingers?
Yes.
Is that what's happening? Is that
the future expands. What we're talking about? We're talking about something different, I think.
Okay, back to the bowl. Back to the boy. Okay, this needs
gifts.
To happen. We're going to work on
we're
this.
Pervert.
We're going
to
work on
this. We're going to gifts. We need gifts.
There's
gifts.
Oh, yes.
A little bit
gifts.
At a time.
Just one.
Not all. All
right. The first one I want to present
Here, would you pass that down to him, sir?
What is this?
You can showcase to the camera as well.
What is happening? Yeah. What do you have there?
Showcase that.
Okay, they're showing that off. Okay.
This light. The
okay. I can't see that on the camera.
Like
we have a small
Casper.
Thing. All right. What are we looking at?
All right. This is a gift.
I have received a gift from the STDs, which is Frozen, and that's the funny-looking snowman guy. Summer Bliss. Can I confess to you, Chest Flexor?
You already have it?
I've never watched Frozen.
Yeah, it sucks.
It doesn't really matter. You're going to read that to us tonight when we're going to bed.
Am I? I may. Maybe there'll be a gold segment where I'll read this. But yeah, so thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
It's a terrible gift.
I think it's
no
a good gift.
You stop
gift.
Going through the gifts, Gary Larry
gift.
Lee.
I don't know if they have
stop
Frozen in the
what
future.
You want. Just put them back.
My bad. I'm sorry. Gary Larry is eating some of your gift. Right
oh,
now.
I can't help this one.
So what's happening?
I have no idea.
Give him another gift. Give him another
I'll
gift.
I'll give him the gift before I eat it myself. There we go.
Oh, there's something
that's
happening.
That's something that he can actually enjoy this holiday season.
We'll show him.
In the future, the tradition is to fart on the cookies of the host of the show that you're going on of any Christmas special. So
too late for that. I already farted. Flex probably smelled it, so...
There you go. So
it's disgusting.
You have to eat at least half
that is
of that.
Absolutely disgusting. All right, but I appreciate you.
So thank you for the sugar cookies. Thankfully, they're very much... move the other one. The one above Rizz. Just move that just so it's straight down. That'll probably help a little bit. So we're working on the lighting situation here. We're just going
to
start over.
Is better.
That's better.
A lot
that's
of the gifts come in doubles, though.
I look like,
what's that?
A lot of the gifts come in doubles. You get two for one.
Okay.
Which is excellent, though, because...
Is this a sale?
Are you ever satisfied with one set of Silly Putty?
Oh.
What the hell is this?
Pass it down.
What is it?
It's noise putty.
It's flarp noise putty.
It's flarp putty.
Flarp noise.
Apparently,
where did you get all this stuff? It's the worst present. I had nothing to do with any of these presents.
You
want to
keep it away
present
from
present
your name's on
the
receipt. What are you talking about?
And conforms
about?
To ASTM D4
Pass
236.
It down.
I don't know what the hell that means. I doubt any child know what that means.
It's terrible.
Can you catch? You drink some vodka here. Let me bump
the
microphone.
You might want to hand that gently.
So we have some flarp noise going on here. Should I open and flarp it?
Do it.
I think you should. Cause
let me
never heard
let me
of
let me
technology.
Work on that. I have a feeling it's going to take me a minute to get this prepared, so we can continue with the interview.
So wait, just stop with the interview. More gifts.
There's
gifts.
More stuff.
More
oh,
gifts.
Geez.
More gifts.
I am embarrassed, man.
I don't
man.
Know what those are.
So all I've given you is the gift of this interview.
Chest Flexor.
I
really don't know what.
We're
that
not
is.
Exactly sure what's in this because this. Which has a bow on it, which I think was stolen.
I did that.
This is a surprise. A minion surprise. You
a
don't
minion,
know
a minion surprise.
What's going to be in the bag. And there are two bags.
Okay.
So we need
two
to open
surprises.
Them.
Two surprises.
I need to open these live, right?
If you want.
I don't think you can open
Christmas.
Them dead.
Well, Eamon, are you horning up out there? I mean, I'm sorry.
I want to know what's inside.
As far as I'm concerned, these belong to you as well. I will share with you in Texas.
We got a present for him.
You got a present for him? Okay, that's cool.
You have to cover the shipping charges.
The shipping, I'll take care of it. I have Amazon Prime. I should be good.
Perfect.
So,
these ones you...
Give me one.
Yeah, that was good. Perfect.
Yes! I got one. There we go.
Sorg, you need a second beer.
I
think it needs
still
more vodka.
Working on the first one, buddy.
All right, we'll get
wait,
to it.
Wait, stop. Before you open that, I think you need
stuff
to.
Ain't free.
We need to do a game. Can I come here, sit next to you for a second?
Yeah, come on over
can
here.
Open
I got a chair over here. Yeah. All right, here
that's
we go.
It's okay, dude. I appreciate it. You're the best.
If you're a regular listener to the Indy Mayhem show, this is not what you usually
my
expect.
Favorite
STD. It's a very special edition.
Got
so, what's going on?
We're going to do a game.
We're going to do a game. Talking to the mic, buddy.
Fucking sick. Your test is going to fall off in a year.
Okay, that's a. So here's the deal. We're going to look on the back of this package.
Yes.
And you are going to try to pick which minion you're going to get. And if you guess wrong, you have to do a shot of vodka. And you have two packages.
I'm going to go for the Gone Batty minion. Gone Batty minion.
It's a good pick.
I think that's a good pick. Usually when a guy from the future tells you that, it's solid.
This game usually works out really well for whoever plays it.
All right, what we got? It's a surprise. It is the. It's the banana minion.
Oh. You know what
you
that means?
Banana.
That means I have
STDs,
to do
bananas. The next gift looks like a banana.
I'm making a tattoo of a
swig.
A banana
is that equivalent
on my bicep?
Maybe two swigs.
Maybe two swigs.
Don't puss out. Let's see it.
No one knows what this. This is the last gift because this is the one Santa made for you.
See, this is.
I'm
how,
glad I got the good bucket tonight. By the way,
this is how Bill Cosby got started too. It was just a fun game, and then you wake up and Bill Cosby's dead.
Chest Flexor.
One more.
Minion 2. I want to go. I want to go. British Invasion. Bob. With a fuzzy hat.
That's terrible
that,
pick.
Terrible. You don't like
you
that pick.
Terrible
pick.
Going to get a shot.
What would you pick? What would you pick?
You already picked it. So.
Okay. There's a bow on this one, so I'm feeling good about it.
I put that bow on there just to trick you.
I feel less good about it.
And I stole it from your garbage can. The bow.
Gary Larry.
You said save him, and somebody threw it away. Right. At least I brought it back.
What is it,
I recycled it how it was supposed to be used.
Another banana guy.
You should have guessed banana.
It's terrible.
Another banana guy.
Who would have thought that the banana?
If you would have stuck with the banana,
it's
both
like
times.
You're doing another shot, Sorg.
But this one has a coat.
These like next set of gifts are way more fun than those.
I'm pretty sure my wife has gone to bed, so I can repackage these for gifts for Christmas.
Yes. Don't.
Thrifty.
She doesn't listen to the show. She hates the show. I won't put them right there. Is that okay?
Oh, that's perfect.
Right there on the computer.
Let me Snapchat. Just clear off the wrappers.
Just clear off the wrappers. To look. This is all about presentation.
Snapchat. Chest Flexor.
All right, so now I got to take two swigs. Is it drinking? It's 100. When you flip digits like this, drinking is appropriate on podcasts. That's
well,
a rule.
What are you drinking right there? What is that?
This is a Click Vodka.
Ooh. Is that like a special edition bottle? I've never seen that bottle.
That's how they roll, man.
Really?
You should have paid $25 and got Virgil here for
like
the 100th show.
Virgil,
only,
I think I'll get
25.
Yeah, he's about. Yeah,
I'll get enough because
what we'll go for.
Because Virgil will be. I've spent enough time between Virgil's living room, filming that thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sounds like a tormenting experience.
Did you guys know Dravico used to be a dancer at the casino downtown?
Thank you.
He would see Virgil there betting his money all the time, and he was like, dude, like, get the hell out of here. Like, I'm so sick of you, like, acting like you're the man.
Is anyone on this show remember
Dravico?
Dravico
almost got in a fight with him a couple
Did he
times.
Wear the mask when he was dancing?
Yes, exactly.
That's weird.
He's an Amazon.
I say that's weird.
Rainforest
and nothing
dancer.
Else, generally.
And nothing else. Wow. Ladies and
forever.
Dudes.
The next gifts we got for you, Sorg, are way more fun, easier to play with.
Okay.
Here's the first one.
Oh, no.
Slap it this way.
That looks like it's rubber.
Now, yeah. Both these gifts are identical in nature, okay. But they're different in their context.
They're different in their context. So this looks like this looks like it's a is it a frog?
It's
a monkey.
It's a combination of everything. You can blow it up. You can slap it around.
What
you
I do?
Can
punch.
Play with it.
It's called
no pun intended.
It's called a punch ball critter.
We'll see what you do is you take that one for yourself.
Good old jam.
And you take this one over here for your lady.
Hold on. So you're saying that's a stocking stuffer.
These things are also glorified.
Well, you blow them up.
They're also glorified 25-cent machine toys. Remember the 25-cent machine toys you would slap on a window and they would stick?
Yeah.
You could grab onto the tail and do the same thing, but they also are inflatable.
Interesting.
Should I
it's
try
interesting.
This?
It's
yes.
It's technology.
Yes,
coming forth.
Does anybody have scissors?
What questions do you have for us, Sorg? What do you want
to
know?
I don't know. We haven't gotten to that yet, I guess.
We're opening gifts right now.
Okay.
We got one more gift to go.
Okay.
This is the last one. I saved
enjoy,
the best for last.
Enjoy your gifts. Please.
Enjoy my gifts. This is going to be amazing. Yeah.
Very good.
I don't know what to expect of this one. I don't know where this gift came from, honestly. I packed this bag full of gifts, and this one found
its
way in.
Special STD gift.
That's an interesting shape.
That's what I know.
Oh, no.
Like I said, I really did pack the bag. This was not in there.
Maybe it's an ice pick.
In the packing of the bag. So somebody snuck this in there recently. I think it was Chest Flexor.
Give me on camera. What is this? what the fuck is this?
I don't know. It's
Let me see. Did it?
That's suspicious. That is suspicious, I gotta say.
Yeah, it's a suspicious shape.
This is weird.
This is weird.
It's
what
cylindrical
is it?
And it's girthy.
You're pretty
Whoever
much just
wrapped
gonna have to
it
rip it
is
open.
Really good at wrapping stuff. That's
to figure
all
out what it is.
This is, it's
No, a female definitely wrapped that. No man would wrap that
no
good.
No man would wrap it that good. No, that's for certain. Because have you seen my wrapping jobs or not?
That's what I mean.
Good.
Like, I never wrapped that
this
good.
This is
solid.
Soft.
Whoa. Soft. Squishy.
All right, we're
going to
maybe it's one of like water squishy things like Chuck E. Cheese's that you can win.
I know what you're talking about. You stick your fingers in.
All right. I'm opening this thing.
Exactly.
It's very
don't talk about ginger like that, Gary.
It's very what? Whoa. Well,
hold it up to the camera.
I'm
excited to see this because I don't even know.
Why is it like torn? Is this used?
Is it used? I really don't know.
Does it work?
Flexor, where'd you get this?
That's not one of mine.
Does it work?
What
the fuck is it?
You don't know. Obvious, Brian. We'll explain it to you later.
It vibrates!
No, oh my god, it's a real one.
That's fucking hilarious.
I didn't know that it was.
Put it with the minions.
Is that a back massager?
It's kind of like another minion, right?
I think it's a minion. Impressive that you stuck that in the bag underneath my watch.
Remind me to put the explicit tag on this show.
You didn't think you'd have to do that? I mean, come on now.
Let's be honest. We usually don't have that for the Indy Mayhem show, but I think it's okay with this one. So what is this?
It's a card.
Did you get me a card?
Yeah,
did you just Hallmark my
Gary
ass?
Gary Larry, wait. Here, put the camera.
What do you got here? What's going on here?
Oh, so
you got
this card's for everyone.
Wow.
Oh my god.
No.
Oh, he went above and beyond for today.
What has happened?
There you go.
He told me to expect anything. I didn't know what. Oh, I ripped the M off with my hair.
Gary Larry. All
right. Gary Larry. All right.
Gary Larry.
Thank you, my friend.
Gary Larry. Gary Larry.
Thank you.
Corey and Barbie Sparkles.
Oh, Barbie Sparkles. There you go. There you go.
It's your girlfriend.
Some deep on
him. Barbie Sparkles dead.
MCD.
Aww. There you go.
What
okay.
are these? We all got gifts too. Thank you, leader.
They're not really much
I
a gift.
You.
I mean, this is how
you're,
a faction
you're
rolls.
You're a good guy, you know.
Right? Right. And by the way, thank you, Mayhem. It says Mayhem Show 500, Mayhem Show 100. You just hand out envelopes to everybody. So what do you got, Lee Rhymes? What do you got there?
I have a beautiful doggy and a kitty looking at each other at a stocking, and it says, "May your holidays be bright and merry." Chest Flexor and Ginger. I'm touched, man. Thank you.
Is an angel, and it says to wish you a joyous Christmas and happiness throughout the coming year.
Oh, you got a snowman drawing.
Nice.
That's a
chance. Nice. Brian, what did you get?
I got a card, very nice card with a tree and a chimney up front. It says, "In the quiet moments of the holidays, may you find peace and joy." There's a name that I can't read.
Probably Ginger.
Two names that I can't read, and a picture of Santa Claus. Very nice.
There you go. I got Santa Claus giving me the eye over there.
I'm happy about this.
Because you're extra special and nice.
I love
the whole year
gifts.
Through. I'm hoping Santa Claus will be just as nice to you. Ginger and Chest Flexor.
In our cards, it has Ginger's real name, which is Ginger La Condia Tuntude. But not many people know that.
Not many people can pronounce that.
I would have a problem with that. And I took French class.
Only in the future.
Well, she's not French.
I remember how to count through 10.
What? I believe she's Spanish.
In French?
Un, deux, trois.
I don't even remember that.
Si, sweat, nice, nos, dix, I do believe.
Le fromage.
All right. We have more surprises.
Oh, no.
Stop speaking Spanish.
More surprises.
Oh,
we've got the gimmick.
Take a look at this, sir. This
look
is pretty,
this.
This is pretty
this
cool.
Is nifty.
What is that?
Buy this for your kids.
It's my beebs.
Watch this.
My beebs.
Hey, you can do
the light. The light is.
Oh, it is a
Sadly, we don't have the flat surface to test
Beavs, on. We're getting ready for the start. The Star Wars is just in a couple of nights as of this recording.
That's why we're doing it. We're getting paid from Star Wars to do this.
Oh, man.
He's a liar, because I certainly didn't get a cut.
So that's why we're doing
What's that?
This.
Wait a minute. What's Beavs?
They're paying us to do this.
Eamon, you've been quiet for a little bit. Are you okay over there? Are you okay over there?
How are you there?
I'm soaking in the holiday spirit.
Eamon, I don't know. Can I take a moment for a second? Eamon is down in Texas. I don't know if they have anything like the sexy, talented dudes down in Texas.
Probably not.
Is Texas another planet?
Basically.
Can you imagine anybody doing what we do, Sorg? I mean, seriously.
No. Absolutely not.
Thank you. Absolutely Thank not. You.
Do you guys remember this time last year I kissed Vicky on the lips, too?
What?
Remember?
Save that story for later.
Yeah, I do remember.
Oh, is this a later story?
And that's when you got an STD.
That's that was actually my like initiation match.
Oh.
That broke me into the group, guys.
Mm-hmm. And then he became strong and powerful.
We'll get to the wrestling talk in a moment. I swear. We're only 25 minutes into this. So what's happened, Chess?
Biebs is trying to tell me something. What's that? Kylo Ren is whose son? And he kills his father? Wait, no, we shouldn't say that. That's what? Spoilers.
Spoilers. So we're going to get some people mad at us. What's going
on? BB-8. I can't believe it. You shouldn't say stuff like that.
No, absolutely not. Absolutely.
Are you seeing Star Wars when it opens, Sorg? Are you seeing Star Wars when it opens?
I am actually going on Thursday night.
Of course you are.
With our friends. With our friend
I
daughters.
Won't be. I have to work till midnight.
And I know, actually, I was at a meeting today, and they were watching a New Hope on their TV, and I was very
jealous. I will see it eventually.
Oh, yeah. But... Oh, man, let's be honest. Everybody's going to see it eventually.
Of course.
Yeah, so definitely. Let me bring us around.
Unless you live.
First
it.
Of all, sexy talented dudes, I knew it was going to be a gift to have you on the show. I did not expect actual gifts to be on the show, so mm-hmm. thank you very much for that. My minions will be well placed throughout the household and surprising my wife. So Chest Flexor.
Yes.
Tell me, like the sexy talented dudes are several years into their history here. Or tell me why sexy talented dudes.
Well, because we're sexy.
Okay. That's a good answer. That's a good answer.
We want proof that we're dudes that we can make that happen.
Mm-hmm.
You stand up and unzip. Is what he's saying. Don't
is that
say.
What I'm saying?
I don't know. Is that what you're saying?
Biebs is coming for you. What's happening? Biebs is coming.
Oh, no. Oh no! There's a droid after me.
What is this power driver muscle video? Music video.
Wait. Bryan McDowell, you've never seen the Power Driver?
Yeah, I have not.
Coco Beware singing like the greatest song, Girls in Cars? Have you just say the words. Say the words Girls in Cars around Joe Dombrowski. And there's a droid attacking my foot. By the way.
The fact that droids exist nowadays is crazy.
Like that's crazy. That's right? Insane.
The fact that it's on a ball too and it fucking travels. It's crazy.
True. Man, I go drink beer all day. This beer tastes great.
It's great.
This is good stuff. This is definitely good stuff.
It's expensive for a 12-pack, though.
Yes, it is. It is.
Don't worry about it. Enjoy it, Sorrel. Drink it up.
There's only two left.
There's two left.
There's two left.
I'm almost done with this one.
God damn it.
Yeah.
This has become a drinking podcast. Eamon, are you doing all right out there?
There's nothing wrong with that.
I'm doing fantastic. I don't have the...
Eamon, do you have any questions for the sexy talented dudes?
He's not paying attention. He's playing Destiny on his Xbox.
Yes, he is.
I could tell.
Do you have any questions for the sexy talented dudes? I know you don't get to see Pittsburgh wrestling so much anymore, but we have some celebrities here in
We should
in
be on
our
pay-per-view, but that's what we're working on.
I guess the best question I can ask these sexy talented dudes is, with the year obviously wrapping up, a few short weeks away, and June 2015 done. What do you look back on 2015? What has the year been like for the sexy talented dudes?
I can't answer that.
Wait.
Flexor should.
I want to point out this year. You guys won the tag team championships, right?
That's true.
We did.
This year?
You guys did. For a different promotion, certainly. You guys were tag team champs for 7 or 8 months, I think.
For a Joe Rogers promotion.
Joe Rogers.
Who actually is a okay friend of mine, actually. Most people don't like Joe Rogers.
The Irons are forever.
He did
and
pay
so
me
is Joe Rogers.
Good too, so, I mean, I was okay with that.
Yeah, Joe Rogers, he's all right. He told me I'm a talented worker, so you know what?
I didn't understand half the words he was saying to me between and after each show. But I just gave him a handshake and said, see you next show. That's how our relationship worked out, pretty much.
I've held a couple tag team championships with Corey Futuristic, Andrew Palace.
That's right. And Bryan McDowell most recently, too, for IWC. You guys had to...
Yes, that recently, was most recently.
It wasn't most recently, about a year ago.
Definitely.
We're going to... Who? I want the over and under. Are we going to get our titles back? That's what I want to know.
Well, you have
I
to,
want the belt back.
You have to get them now from the fraternity, of course, that won at this last show Saturday at Winner Takes All. Do you see them as stiff competition? And would you be drinking buddies with the fraternity?
Yeah, I mean, I think we should be drinking buddies with them.
Yeah, I mean, would, after I beat them up, him. Sure.
I'd beat them in beer pong.
After I take what I want, I'll hang out with them. But this is business, and I want my title back.
Because you outdrink them. What do you think?
Yeah, Bryan probably could outdrink them.
I drink a lot of beer. I don't know what number this
could
is.
Could you
but
beat him in beer pong, though?
So.
That's where their
What's
stick
that?
Is. Could you beat him in beer pong?
I'm not that good at beer pong, unfortunately.
I know the rule.
I'll practice it.
We'll play together. We'll get it together. We can beat him. I don't know about in ring, but we could definitely do it on the table.
I don't even know the one guy's name. I only there's like Honestly, the, there's like the names. Shawn Michaels, and then there's the Marty Jannetty. I don't even know what the Marty
I was
going to
say there's
who was the Shawn Michaels and Marty Jannetty out of McDowell and myself?
I don't know.
I would vote for him.
I'm going to answer that.
I would give you the Michaels and you the Jannetty. No offense.
You're not. Flexor's Michaels.
Yeah, I would give Flexor the Michaels, man. All
right. I mean, whatever.
I mean, he was the leader of DX. He was the leader of STDs. I mean.
He is. He is. Flexor. I want everybody to know. Flexor is a great human being. He really is. He's a great friend of mine. And
his shoes are amazing. Can you bring your
we
shoes
We have
up
been
to the
champs
camera?
Before. I believe one day we will be again. And Flexor's a good. He's a good.
Why are you
he's
laughing at
partner
like that?
He's a good human.
He's a good human. He's a good human. Yeah. He's gonna be. Oh wow. Hey, what's
happening? Stop making out on the couch over there. Seriously, settle down.
I love Chest Flexor. I love all these guys. It's great.
I gotta say, early on, sexy talented dudes. Back when he had some guy that had frizzy hair.
Andrew Powell.
This is what, the second time you brought him up now.
Well, geez.
Today? Why do you do that?
You got a man crush?
Why do you do that?
Well, he was just on the show a couple weeks ago, so he's present on.
And he mentioned us. It was awesome.
You have that erection going on, and all you can think about is Andrew Palace.
Yeah, right.
I mean, just because he like hangs out with me at Dunkin' Donuts, I mean, it's no big thing, man.
And he was a comeback person on your show, I do believe, right? He came back.
He was the second time. He's one of the very few second time.
It's garbage. Get rid of it.
No. You want to delete the episode? What was it?
No. I mean, I'm just saying. Just don't get so excited. About Andrew Powell.
I think he needs to do another shot. That's what I think.
Me?
I've never done it.
Me? Yes, yeah, you.
Come on. We gave you all these gifts. Do a shot
Bryan
for us.
Bryan McDowell will do a shot with you.
Me too.
I certainly will.
So will Wildchild.
Wildchild, Gary, Larry.
Bryan McDowell, come over.
Lee. B-Rax's
Listen,
mom,
you're the
Ryan,
reason. You're the
Evans.
Only reason that stupid name lives with us to this day.
What stupid name?
That
Lee
that,
Ryan's?
That, no.
I'm sorry.
No, Gary, Larry, Lee. That blasphemy go, name brother. That has somehow been linked to my here. Existence.
Just because your mother raped you and she gave you Gary Larry
my
Lee
as a
name.
My mother's a fucking saint, bro.
Yeah, you would
Don't
say that.
Don't talk about her in vain. She gives me great Christmas gifts.
I bet she gives you great Christmas gifts, huh?
You would know.
She got that mistletoe.
Pervert.
Cheers. All right,
Ask Gary Larry Lee Rhines about the time he made out with B-Rax's mom.
What?
Since then, she has not attended an IWC show.
I haven't seen her for a while.
Exactly.
I gotta be honest. Can you explain for those that there are not, like for Eamon? Eamon's in Texas. He's in San Antonio. Home of Shawn Michaels. And he does not know.
Very nice.
He does not know B-Rax. I know he received a King Crown CD when he visited Cleveland at one time.
I wish you could do like a quick link in the comment section, like to give him like a link to B-Rax's SoundCloud page. Yes. Like, seriously, that would be ideal right now.
But
so he could understand who he is.
Verbally, can you tell him the deal with B-Rax?
B-Rax.
Explain the B-Rax phenomenon in Pittsburgh.
The best story I can say about B-Rax, and this is a story that has nothing to do about me kissing his mother, which did happen. Like, that did happen.
That happened at a show, right?
The best thing I can say about B-Rax is Jimmy Nuts. He just recently won the IWC Heavyweight Championship. He came up with me a story backstage, and he said, a gentleman came up to me, and he was referring to B-Rax, and he said, my mommy needs a new daddy. And he was referring to Vicky that was at the show, which I also continued to kiss to earn my rightship to become an STD. You know, that's what I did. You know, Chest Flexor Triple Dog dared me to do it, and I did
all
it.
All right. Lee.
I regret it to this day.
Lee, I got questions. I got questions for you in particular right now. Okay.
I have answers.
You're not one of the original STDs.
Nope. Replaced Andrew Palace.
You're the replacement for Andrew Palace.
Almost beat him in my debut match.
That's right. That's right. Respect. Respect. What do the STDs mean to you?
What did the STDs mean to me? That's an excellent question and something I was not prepared to answer.
Kill yourself.
No, I don't want to kill myself over getting an STD. I think getting an STD is the best thing that could happen in my wrestling career right now. Yeah, I think it was really good, you know?
Yeah.
My character epitomized something that STDs represented, and Chest Flexor is the face of that, and I'm happy to be a part of such a prestigious organization.
What?
Do you have an issue?
The whole year, Gary Larry has learned nothing, obviously.
Wait, when did you...
Are you serious?
When did you become an STD?
Yeah, exactly. When did he become an STD?
Seriously. We're talking about that. I think I said when I kissed Vicky, that was our second match together. The match before that, we faced Kato, Brian Bowers, and the Knight Riders, I do believe, with Wyatt.
Was that a Clearfield show?
It was a Clearfield show.
Okay.
We were tagged together with some gentleman from Cleveland with half face paint. I don't remember his name because he never showed up in Pittsburgh ever again.
And there's lost tapes of Gary Larry doing all types of crazy stuff to enter the STDs.
But after that, I never got a notification. Plummer or Roberts or Chest Flexor never messaged me like, hey, you want to be a part of an STD? I just got one day. And I just got to be a part of it.
Wait. First of all, Chest Flexor, you're beside me. Please talk into the mic. Now, what is the process to become an STD, and I'll move the camera here so you can be on over here.
Well, there's actually video of the process to become an STD. There are a few videos. I have them on my phone. I could show you them.
Not necessary for the course of the show. Some people listen to us in audio. That's okay.
But I will show you them privately. We do have the requirements film.
Is that the eating contest?
It was similar.
No.
Something with hot sauce.
Not the eating contest.
And a cookie. I remember it. I was there.
You know, King Frown actually has a relative who is in the professional wrestling business.
Yes, he does.
I have no clue.
I have heard of such a thing.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Okay. I want to show you something.
What? Remember, we're live on YouTube right now.
I want to show you something, but you have to give me a promise.
No, yeah, do it. Post that.
He deserves it. You probably won't remember this anyway, but you have to promise me.
That's probably the most push he's ever done. you won't tell
anybody or repeat. What you see.
I don't think I want to see it.
You don't want to see it?
I don't think I want to see it. Eamon, do you want to see it?
No.
I can't show it
on the Wrestling Mayhem show. I can only show you personally.
Feeling good?
Okay.
We should have bought a fucking case.
Why am I saying okay?
Just because we made it to 500.
It's 500 episodes of the Wrestling Mayhem show. This is 100 of the Indy Mayhem show.
I want you to read this, not out loud. This is going to be like, Corey, can you dance for us to give somebody entertainment while I show
this? Probably the worst audio podcast ever, by the way.
Corey, you can go into the future and the past.
Do your dance, Corey. Come on, do your dance.
Do you know who that is?
I'm not going to do that.
No.
That's overflowing. Oh, you jabron. My bad.
Okay.
We just spilled beer everywhere.
You might have seen him before.
I might have heard of him. I might have heard of him.
I want you to read this. Now remember, you can't tell anybody about this. You can't tell anybody about
this. I can't tell anybody about this.
Hey, Eamon.
Should we wait till we're off air?
Eamon?
No.
Okay.
No.
I just want to say, check your messages.
Okay. I'm doing a podcast.
Rizz is on here.
This is the most important thing in his life right now. The STDs are on the podcast. This is very important. This is very historic, really. This podcast will probably be worth a lot of money someday, so... Want everybody to save this.
That is the weirdest thing. And can I say that's maybe the weirdest thing I've ever seen?
What did you show?
That could be the weirdest thing I've seen around pro wrestling.
What did you
if
show?
If I got the context right.
I still don't even know what he showed him.
Yeah, I don't know either.
Listen.
Was it something I was involved with? I have to come over there and look.
Riz, I don't understand what you're trying to show me.
I don't.
This is getting weird.
He's the leader of my group, and I don't know what he's showing Sorg over here. Hey. He's showing him some videos, and Sorg's getting all giggly.
Can't tell anybody.
Only
one other person.
Riz really wanted to see B-Rax's second.
Your lover, Andrew Palace, has seen
it. Listen, like, I gave him the innuendo to click on it, but like, listen to it for like 5 seconds and just back out, because it's not worth it.
Okay.
Just to get the idea of who. Just to get the idea of who.
Oh, I'm not going to burn that out of my brain anytime soon.
Was it?
Nope.
I know what he's showing.
Nope.
What is he showing?
Take that away from my face.
Is that that super infamous question, wait, stop.
Listen. Stop. What questions stop. You offer us? Stop. Now think back to the first thing I showed you.
Yeah. Oh! Ladies and gentlemen, indie wrestling.
All right, so we're playing.
Can we just...
What do you want to know?
Right
interview
now.
Us.
Yeah,
like no more. 500, it's over. 100,
it's over. It's over. All right, I got a question. Listen. All
right, good.
I got a legitimate wrestling question. Oh, just stop showing me that. Stop.
Please do. Ask us questions. We're going to ask questions.
I want to put this back on me.
We're here for their entertainment, so we want to be very entertaining.
Don't push it, though, Brian. Why can't I see this?
Don't push it.
I got questions. First of all, Bryan McDowell.
Who the hell was
okay, yes, yeah, sir.
So, I respect
the
stage that you have brought bowling to the wrestling ring.
Thank you. I'm doing my best.
Good question.
Thank you so much. As we mentioned, I'm a bowler.
Let's go bowling sometime.
I'm down to 70.
We should go bowling
down at Hollywood Lanes down in Dormont.
I'm down, Sorg. Let me know.
This needs to happen, like, and we're going to periscope the entire thing.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Why? I won't say any other words.
Why bowling and pro wrestling?
Why bowling and pro wrestling?
Yes. Why did you bring bowling to pro wrestling?
That is a great question. I mean, I wasn't able to touch anybody in bowling. I mean, I've had instances where I've crossed the line and I've got, you know, I got disqualified from meets. And I just wanted to give somebody a good old-fashioned Bret Hart backbreaker. And I wasn't able to do that as bowling. And I met this character. I said, you know, yo, I bowl, but I also want to fight people. And he said, I got you. And here I am. I do both.
Is that how it went exactly?
That's exactly how
it went. I never heard that story before.
I never heard that story either.
That's the first time I ever heard that story.
That was a good story, though.
That was a good one.
If I had to pick one, I guess I'd pick wrestling over bowling, but it's a tough one. It really is.
And obviously, you've been very inventive. The bowling ball, I've never been as a bowler myself, I've never been able to perfect that towel gimmick that you do.
Yeah,
you do shine that
was
balls
just,
nicely.
Sort of, I got that the first day. I just naturally was just able just to
polish those balls.
And I respect the natural
balls.
Talent.
It's
I respect
natural
the natural talent.
You either have it or you don't.
Usually when it comes to we're talking to a lot of pro wrestlers on here, and I don't know the first thing. I know the first thing, but obviously I'm not a pro wrestler, right? I'm the guy behind the camera.
I don't know. I've seen some videos,
but bowling, I'm familiar with.
You're okay, Sorg.
One of these days, we're going to make you cameraman. You're going to take a bump.
We're going to go bowling.
Are we taking a bump?
We're going to do an Undertaker spot over the ropes, and we're going to pull you in.
He's
going to
do
it. Just like that one WrestleMania.
I'm behind the switcher. That's Chachi, you got to do it.
You're
going
to switch with Rob Brown one day. You're going to show him exactly what you do.
Who?
That guy that handles the cameras. Your cameras. They're probably your cameras.
I don't know if you know.
You don't even know your own employees?
You know Chachi. Chachi has taken a bump
Joni
from...
loves Chachi.
Chachi has taken a bump. The guy that's usually ringside at the IWC,
what's
he has taken a bump from...
Bump of cocaine? What are you talking about?
Yeah. I don't understand.
What are you talking
this?
About?
He has taken a nut shot from Mr. Jock Sampson.
Oh, really?
At some promotion.
This must have been before I
started.
This is over at some promotion you were never a part of.
Oh, wow.
I'm not going to mention it. We talked about a lot of Wrestling Mayhem Show this week. 500 episodes. Holy shit. Forget my point.
Do a shot.
Yeah.
Shot.
Come on, Sorg.
Shot.
Gary,
shot.
Go do
shot.
One with him.
Go ahead. Yeah, I'm good on shot right now.
I want one anyway.
Why not? This is good shit. Bye-bye. Click vodka. Good stuff.
Chest Flexor, when I went to his house, he gifted me with...
Talk to the mic.
When I went to Chest Flexor's house right before we came here, he gifted me with a moonshine shot from Tennessee.
Ooh.
It was 150
Gary,
proof and
Gary
delicious.
Larry, that was not moonshine.
What was it?
Do I need to edit this?
What
later?
Was it? He also
just take a shot.
He also followed
just
me up with a shot of tequila.
Take a shot. Eamon, how you doing?
Burn.
I want to know when is
burns.
Corey going to get a title shot?
Who?
Corey.
Corey.
Yeah.
Hey, let me talk about Corey.
A heavyweight title shot. It needs
Corey
to happen.
Futuristic. Corey Futuristic.
At
I
least,
have questions for
at
you.
At least an entry in Super Indy this year. Has
I have
be,
questions
right?
for you. First of all, yes. Corey Futuristic, you should get at least first round in the Super Indy tournament.
I agree.
Of course.
I agree.
Yeah, you're the weight class,
or
you're perfect.
The,
yeah, yeah, I don't see why
I mean, there's all these fat guys in the Super Indy division now, and it's like it's about skinny little midget people doing
You're like a third of Ray Rowe, who's in the Indy tournament last year.
Yeah, that is true.
Right. All due respect. I respect Corey Futures. Let me ask you a question.
He lasted in the Rumble long over the weekend, too.
He did.
We all did.
Good stuff.
That,
respect
you know what,
for
you know
that.
I was going to say that. I should say this. The STDs went into the match
five.
With one mission. Bulk Nasty does not win. Did Bulk Nasty win? No. Mission accomplished.
To win the Battle Royal, I believe.
Yeah, yeah. Screw Bulk Nasty. He's a douche.
I mean, I should have won, but Bulk Nasty didn't win. That was the mission. Bulk Nasty, we're coming for you. We're not done with you.
And you know what the problem was? You didn't bring your bowling ball with you.
That was,
it was
issue.
Out there. It was out there.
It was out there?
It was out there.
I don't know. I was busy doing other things.
I mean, during the match, it wasn't there. I wasn't allowed to do that. I had
why
some
not?
Restrictions.
What are the rules of the Battle Royal?
It's a Battle Royal. Are there rules to the Battle Royal? Are there no, you
I was
can get disqualified to the
right
Battle Royal.
2 feet touch the floor after you go to the top rope. You're limited.
That's a good
That's
question.
It. That's it. You could have
yeah,
done.
Really.
Dude, you could have done a Kofi Kingston.
I want to know. I want to
from this point
I want
on, I'm entering rumbles
too.
With chairs.
How
I'm
many
locking
people,
in with chairs.
How many people think I should name my bowling ball? I have some ideas. I kind of
want
to name my ball.
Okay, Corey, I'm going to get to you. Brian?
Yes.
What do you want to name your bowling ball?
What's one? Dear Agony.
What?
Dear Agony.
I think you should
I
name
like
it.
That. You were confident on that answer, man. You
oh,
were
I know. I
you were thinking about
you've been
that
thinking
really
about this.
I talk to my
ball.
I
never
every,
even thought.
I talk to my ball every night. I talk to
it.
I
talk
to it. I talk to it.
Anything he sticks three fingers in is Dear Agony. That's why.
I think you should name it Betsy.
Betsy, I know
Brian.
Betsy. I never really liked her.
Brian,
so
Brian,
never stuck
Brian.
Three fingers in Betsy.
I still have the bowling ball from my high school junior league career.
We need to
upstairs.
What type
team.
Of balls do you have, Brian?
We need to use that for a show. My balls have been won in tournaments, all of them.
Wow, is that shoot? Is that shoot?
Is that shoot? Yes.
What are you
shooting? You're a raw dog, bro.
How many bowling balls do you have, Brian?
Four.
How many pairs of shoes?
I believe four.
I want
one pair of shoes.
I've been waiting for this to have the heart to heart to Brian here. Like legit, you're like a legit bowler. Like let me know.
Time
your,
for another shot.
Tell the truth, Brian.
Your bowling history here.
Yes.
Yes.
Hey, yes.
Yes.
When did
yeah,
you
I
first
love bowling.
Put your fingers?
Have you
in
done a 300?
Why hasn't
yes.
anybody seen a trophy?
He's done a 300 plus
Brian.
Before. I've Flexor's
seen
pictures. Seen
it, yes. Flexor's seen it.
Flexor's seen it? Flexor?
I've seen him do the over 300.
Yeah.
Talk to my grade school. That's where I started, and I was able to win a bunch of tournaments there. So I just.
So
gradually...
this was the natural fit when you went to pro wrestling, said bowling.
Bowling. I mean,
bowling.
Bowling. I mean, wrestling is more important than bowling, but bowling is important, definitely.
There's
bowling.
No belts in wrestling, or in bowling.
There's a ring.
I have trophies, so I have many trophies.
There's a lot of rules, though, and there's champions.
I can't remember a trophy in pro wrestling since Bad News Brown.
What? You're right, but that trophy is hey, Justin Plummer, let's make a trophy.
That's right.
Come on, let's make a trophy. Make a tag title or a tag team trophy. I don't know, you know.
Corey Futuristic.
Hello.
I have questions for you.
Okay.
We just celebrated Wrestling Mayhem Show 500.
Yeah.
We've been doing this for 10 years.
10?
I'm out of fingers.
10 years ago, I was in high school. God damn.
And were you listening to Wrestling Mayhem Show?
Fuck no.
Then what's wrong with you?
I'm sorry. What are you doing?
Come on. Corey Futuristic, I have a question for you. Mm-hmm. You know the future.
Of course.
You were trained by Noel Gowan.
Mm-hmm.
I met the kid.
Yes.
He's a very nice one-year-old. Mm-hmm. What does Wrestling Mayhem Show 1000 have in store for us?
Well, unfortunately, Nick Swartzen is going to take over your show in 10 years, and he is going to turn into a transvestite, and the show is going to be all about fashion and paint chips. So, I'm sorry, in 3 years' time, that all happens, and I know that doesn't sound like that much time, but trust me, it happens.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the last edition of the Indy Mayhem Show.
Sorry.
What a show to go out on. What a show.
It's
horrible.
Sorg, what else do you want to know about us?
How's your friend from San Antonio, Texas doing? I haven't seen him in a while.
Everybody in the chat room.
Is he still alive?
Eamon!
Yeah, do we have any questions?
He is a wrestling fan. This is the first year where he's allowed to drink.
He asked one question and disappeared.
Do you have any question for the sexy...
I want to answer his questions.
Do you have any questions for the sexy, talented dudes?
Well, I guess the only thing I can ask is, from Corey Futuristic, he predicted the future of the WrestleMania show. What's in my future, Corey?
I think you can answer a lot of questions like that. What's in my future, too?
I don't know what...
You are our own personal Magic 8-Ball.
Am I?
Yes.
Do you think I follow around every single person in the future, and that's my job when...
No, I think that I can shake you... And you can say, the future is bright.
That is true. Do you want to know who the president is in 20 years?
I do.
Do it.
I do.
It is, believe it or not, Bill Cosby. Believe it.
Corey
I
Futuristic.
It first.
You're from the future. You're trained by Noel Gowan.
Mm-hmm. Who are you trained by?
What is... the biggest, most devastating move of the 31st century.
It is the cock slap, actually. It's this triple indie move. It was invented by, who was that Chest Flexor that invented that? Met in the future?
I believe you told me it was Nick Hogan's son.
Yes, Nick Hogan's son. Gerald Hogan.
Named after Gerald Briscoe.
You're making up stuff. You guys are making up stuff, and I appreciate it with what I've learned throughout my
life.
This
is why Larry struggles so much, because he doesn't believe me. He doesn't believe in the magic. He doesn't believe in the future and the power.
I believe in you. I tried to save your life at the Rumble over the weekend.
Kiss him.
You fell into me.
This is the first guy eliminated out of the STDs.
Kiss him.
I eliminated two people before you were eliminated. Who did you eliminate?
You're not drunk. You'll kiss him.
Did you eliminate somebody?
I eliminated Keith Hott with Wardlow and Wyatt.
Who the fuck is Wyatt?
The guy that had the tag team partner less than a year ago was some guy named Sam. I think his name was Sam.
Who the fuck is Wyatt?
Wyatt.
Yeah, who's Wyatt?
No, you're right. You're absolutely right. I don't know who that is.
That is impressive that he picked up Keith Hott, though. I would not be able to pick up Keith Hott for the life of me.
I got a beef because I'm a fan of Keith Hott, friend of the show. Gives me a hug every show. I see him. Good dude.
He is very cuddly.
He is. He is.
His name is Remy LeVay.
Rizz.
Yeah, he still didn't get it.
Yeah.
Rizz, peek in there. Peek in there. You are the IWC historian, second only to Mayhem Missy, that I believe. Do you have any questions for the sexy, talented dudes?
I'm just enjoying the show.
Do you have any questions from the future for Wrestling Mayhem Show 1000 from Corey Futuristic?
Do we have any special guests for 1000 at all?
For 1000, you have the special guest of the ghost of Jimmy Snuka.
Oh, so he's returning. He's a returning guest. Okay.
Yes. He is back from the dead, and he's ready to kill again. So get ready for it. It's a Halloween episode. This one's all about gifts, but the Halloween one's all about killing.
Eamon, do you have any questions about Wrestling Mayhem Show 1000 recording Futuristic? Listen, if we have a man from the future, you need to take advantage of this, even if you live in Texas.
I think we have everything we need to do. Snuka's coming back. Yeah, it's going to be great. It'll be a great 1000th episode.
All right.
And I have minions. And I have minions.
Oh, there's more. There's more. Don't forget. There's more.
There's more?
Gary, there's no beer left, Gary.
No more left.
Is there any alcohol for Bryan the Lion?
On that point, Chest Flexor.
There's more. Don't give up on us yet. It's 12:31. Holy crap.
That was the end of it.
Chest Flexor, you are a constant in indie wrestling here locally in Pittsburgh.
I need a plug.
what
you're out of battery life.
No, I need no.
Chest Flexor.
Yes, ma'am.
No, man. Go back on the mic. Get back behind the mic. Where are you going?
Where are you going?
Don't unplug the podcast machine.
You said I could have a plug.
What?
You said I could have a plug.
Yeah, there's one like right here or something, right? You see one there? You see one there?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Go, Bryan.
Yes.
Lee Evans. All right. I got a standby question. Lee Evans. We got the bowler.
You son of a bitch.
That's Scott Steiner.
Listen, if you called me Gary Larry, I'd accept it, but you're not even getting close. You know what? I don't feel bad about calling him Wyatt anymore. That fucking Remy LeVay. Jesus Christ.
Chest Flexor. He's from the future. Brian's from the holding alley. Chest Flexor. No more words I need to say.
Wait.
Remind me again. What does Lee Ryan's bring to the table in the sexy talented dudes?
I bring a whole lot of fucking sexy and talented to the dudes. I can tell you that right now. We're going to hit the singles competition, me and Corey, next year in 2016. We're going to light it up. Chances are I'm probably going to have to face you at some point. And, that might be shitty. If it happens, I'm sorry. I'm going to apologize now. I'm going to pile driver you.
Is the future... Answer me, because you know. Is the future, winner takes all, 2016... a ladder match, because that seems to be in vogue in December for some reason. Corey Futuristic, Lee Ryan's ladder match. Is that going to happen?
No, that's definitely not.
I don't think a ladder match.
Of course not. No, that is not going to happen.
What will happen?
It is going to be...
me and Flexor will have a ladder match at some point.
It's going
really?
To be yeah. Lee
really?
Ryan's.
You think you two?
It's going to be Lee Ryan's versus... Vicky B-Rex's mom in a fraternity ladder match.
Listen, that happened last night. I won. I'm going to tell you that right now.
All right. On that point.
B-Rex's mom ran away
Eamon?
With a child molester.
Eamon? Yeah.
Don't believe Gary Larry Lee.
Yes, sir.
We have a set of questions that we do on the outset.
We do?
I would like you to administer those.
Are we talking? Okay.
That's Sorg's way of saying he's dying.
For the rest of the show, but let's go with it. I'll do all of the sexy, talented dudes. The normal questions we have are: first off, what are you watching currently in professional wrestling? What do you have your eyes on?
Chest Flexor, what are you watching right now? What are you watching right now?
In professional wrestling.
In professional wrestling, who has your attention? Who are you inspired by? What's going on out there?
Go ahead, Brandon.
I watch everything I can, honestly. Anything.
Yeah.
Yes.
Everything, even wrestling.
Anything I can. I mean, I always see it. I mean, I'm obviously entertained by it. I'll always be a fan, but I'm learning. I'm always learning. I'm always watching, looking for those little things. I'm always learning, and I wish I had more time to watch more wrestling. Honestly, I don't have enough time, but I watch everything.
Chess, you're not in front of the mic. So we'll go over
to Gary Larry.
We'll go over here.
What was the question? Reiterate the question one more time.
Lee Ryans, what are you watching in professional wrestling right now? What has your attention? What's inspiring you right now?
The number one thing I like in professional wrestling is the old school category on the WWE Network. For some reason, I think the psychology of the prior to 1990 was the apex of what wrestling psychology was. Ever since then, it just kind of dropped down, and that's just the stuff I try to study and try to mimic, bring it back.
Awesome. Corey Futuristic, what are you watching in pro wrestling in the future?
Not shit.
What?
Business fail.
Raw.
Is that why you're back here? Because it sucks in the future? Does it get worse?
I travel through all this wrestling because it's crap. And yeah, I barely watch anything on wrestling. Lucha Underground's good.
Yeah, even like how many seasons does it get by the time it reaches
second...
you?
Season coming on soon, though.
Now, yes, friend of the show, Chris Joseph, being on the show.
It has 1,000 seasons in the future.
I can't wait to see what Pentagon Jr. goes and his grandparents.
Mm-hmm. Certainly. Marvelous.
Marvelous. Dave, wait, sorry, are you giving me a hint? Is it going to be bought by Disney?
Yes.
Can I get Gary Larry Lee to come over here?
Go ahead. What's happening?
What do you need?
What's happening?
Well, I was inspired. Corey Futuristic shaved his head.
Yeah, I was going to shave my head on the show, but I decided I did not.
Holy crap.
I did not trust my group mates to shave my head because I knew that they would be drinking today. So.
Well, I could do it.
I decided to shave it before
you're drinking
I came
too,
here.
Sir.
Well,
actually, I
consider
not
the shave,
but I'm not able to shave Corey's head. But I was inspired by Corey, so I would like Gary Larry Lee to help me right here. Hello? Is this echoing?
Yeah, you're on. You're going to shave your head here on the show?
Gary Larry Lee is going to help me.
Gary Larry is...
I've been inspired. 500th episode.
What is going to happen?
Wow.
100th episode.
Aw.
Chest flexor. Get the cameras
ready. Wait. You've had a ponytail for as long as I've known you as a fan of IWC Wrestling.
Oh,
where are you going? Why are your pants undone?
I think I know what he's about.
My ass hasn't been shaved in a while. Gary Larry,
whoa,
shave my ass.
Shave my ass.
Camera.
Come on.
I don't know about your soda.
Where's the camera?
Oh, my God.
Come on, get in there.
No, get it on.
Get in there, Gary. Come on, get in there.
Right up. Whoa.
No.
No. Just get. I have a tuft of hair that needs. Do you see it?
God,
there you go. I've been growing it out.
I don't think I can show that. Or you get kicked off of YouTube. I don't know what happened there.
Gloves on.
Where's my goddamn gloves?
Why does he have gloves? Why do you have gloves on? What is happening? I gotta be honest. This is probably not the worst thing that's been shown on YouTube. So. I mean,
it's okay. You can show.
You're very
man.
Gentle.
That looks nice, bro. I'm just saying.
How's it look? Can we get a? Is the chat room Rizz, going?
Rizz, can we get? Can we get a verdict on this?
That's so good.
How's it looking?
The camera.
That's a bare ass, bro. There's no more hair on that.
Only goes to me, by the way.
Worst thing is, Eamon sees the ass no matter what I switch to.
God.
For the STDs, we're good for some disturbing fucking memories. That's for
sure.
Well,
disturb.
All right, now Brian, you said you were gonna shave your face, right?
I'm gonna do it tonight. I'm gonna do it now.
You want to do it now?
I don't.
Well, we have it ready. You don't want
to. Ladies and gentlemen,
should I do it, Sorg? Do you want me to do it? I'm sure my girlfriend does. My girlfriend wants me to get
rid
of this beard.
Eamon,
should we continue with any other questions?
The leader of the STDs.
I don't know how we got that, sir.
I'm not afraid of much.
Chest Flexor.
Yes.
Chest Flexor. I love you.
Do another shot. Shot!
No, no,
do another
shot.
Yeah!
Come on. 500. 100. Do another shot.
Corey, do a shot, please.
Corey?
Corey, I'll do one with Sorg.
Do one
with Sorg. Please, we'll be fine.
Listen.
You'll be fine. For the future, you don't get pulled over for drinking.
If you're a regular listener to the Indy Mayhem Show, I apologize. But this is some good stuff.
was a lot of fun.
It is good.
We're
it,
celebrating.
It has some tingle to the boy or to the
this,
group. It's good
this,
though.
This group of people are the guys that show up every month. I see them at IWC, which is a fantastic promotion, Corey. Right? Mm-hmm. Right? Good stuff.
Yeah,
good stuff.
It's the best.
Best in Pittsburgh.
You guys
down.
Are a lot of fun.
Best in Pittsburgh, hands down.
But you guys are cool. Thank you so much for coming out for the triple-digit rollover for the Wrestling Mayhem.
Thank you, Sorg. It was fun.
It's a
Thank
pleasure
you.
To be First here. I'm very honored to be
any,
here.
Any last questions for the Kingpin? Anything?
I'm very upset that it's been so long since I've had to make my return. I should be on more constantly with the rest of these gentlemen.
We should.
My ass hair does not regularly get that long, but we only get together at certain times,
That's
like
true.
Today, so you
That's
need
true.
To bring us together so my rear
so,
end could get shaved, my posterior
you?
Can be smooth.
I give you cheers.
No final questions, Sorg?
Oh, wait. What's the final question, Eamon?
Final question.
Wait. Who won the final question? First, I want to shoot shot.
Shot. Hell
yeah.
Eamon getting the. Corey from the future. Where everybody's named Eamon.
I want to say one thing before we get off the air.
Get it, mother!
I want to say one thing before we go off the air.
What? Kill me now.
Bryan McDowell believes in God. What? So should you.
Wow, that's not
yes,
more
I pray. I pray every day, all day, and God's always helping me, so he will
you
help
say
you
say a prayer
too.
For the STDs and for the Sorg, Wrestling
Mayhem
say
a prayer for us right now. Sorg,
I will do that later. Eamon, what is the final question?
Okay, I'm sorry.
Final question to all the STDs. What is the best and the worst thing about independent wrestling?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, this is a good question.
You should have started off with
this. Is this a shoot answer? Can we give this a shoot answer?
What does that
this
mean?
This whole interview is supposed to be a shoot, and you guys are giving all these types of weird answers.
No, I really want to know the future, man.
You told me that it wasn't a shoot interview.
Well, obviously, I'm going to answer the future, because I am shoot from the future.
Right.
Basically, Corey just told you I'm lying.
I'll say this. The worst thing... Worst thing is working with people that don't know what they're doing.
Bullshit.
That's what I think.
I was going to counter that. I would say the worst thing about indie wrestling would be Joe Rogers. He left a company right after running like 16 shows consecutively, and we actually did a good job. And that mofo sold his company to Code
Red.
He sold
his company?
He sold his company. I'm sorry, sold his company to I don't even know the promotion because I
refuse to work
for them.
Code Red Wrestling, friends of
the show.
Has
anyone even gone to their events in the last 6 months?
No.
Exactly.
Whoa, exactly. We got some
That's
problems.
Probably the worst my worst blemish on professional wrestling since I've started was that whole debacle. The best thing about it would probably be you guys. I appreciate the opportunity to work with a prestigious group of gentlemen that have done what they have done in the last 2 or 3 years. I really appreciate it. It's a good opportunity. I
Thank
like
you,
it.
Gary.
Can I say this? The sexy talented dudes have been the most fun thing I look forward to every month in pro wrestling. I can't wait to see what
Thank
you guys
you,
are doing.
Thank you, Sorg. That means a lot. We try to
even
try
when
to make
even
you
when
laugh,
Corey
you know?
Gets the shit slapped out of him in Clearfield, that is
That's
very fun for me
Corey's
as well.
The biggest badass in this room.
Yeah.
He is.
Dude,
not the biggest bear ass, though. Flexor, though, takes the cake.
That Corey takes the shit that he does. Fucking respect.
Yes.
Thank you.
Biggest badass in the room.
You
this
know,
man
once...
has been choked out by Virgil. He has been Vader bombed. What else has happened to you?
Wait. And remember, Chest Flexor, speaking of the
yeah,
Virgil
Chest
Flexor's connection,
there with this.
Chest
too.
Flexor, the, what'd you call yourself? The billion dollar man?
Not that I was the billion dollar man.
You were the billion dollar man. I hope you can Patreon this show, by the way, as a side note. And having your moment up there with the million dollar man, Ted DiBiase and Franklin PA. Respect. Pleased to have filmed that as well.
I once saw Corey almost beat up two very large human beings in a movie theater when they were trying to pick on Bryan McDowell.
tell a story, Corey. Listen to this. Yeah, Corey, tell a story.
Well, we went to see The Conjuring in theaters. Have you seen that movie?
No.
It's pretty good. It's about
right.
a ghost. Well, there was these people at Lowe's Theater that kept on talking the entire movie. And as you can
Fuck
tell from this interview, Bryan is batshit crazy.
Yes.
So, by the time the movie ended, Bryan was very mad, and this person kept on talking. He said, "Please be quiet."
By me. Just like that?
Yeah, kind of. Yes. Just a lot more angry.
Honestly, yes.
Respect. Respect. Bryan, do it.
He said, "Please be quiet."
I was like, "Will you please be quiet for the end of the movie?"
I'm a bowler. Don't fuck with me.
Yeah, that's exactly what
he should have realized that. But
the movie ends, and then the guy is like, "Yeah, I pissed you off, didn't I? I pissed you off or whatever." So I'm like, "What the fuck?" I'm like, "This dude's really gonna talk shit whenever we got all the STDs," and that was even back whenever Andrew Pallas was with us. So we could have taken him because Andrew Pallas is there, and he's like Mega Man or something. Yes. But so I was like, "This dude's trying to talk smack," and we got all four out. I was like, "Shut the fuck up or we'll beat your ass," or whatever. And then Bryan, since I stuck up for him, he was like, "Yeah," he's like, "Get the fuck out of here." He's like, "Get the hell out of here." And then his girlfriend ended up throwing like a Mountain Dew on Bryan. And
Sprite,
then
actually.
We were just like, "All right, see you later." Like, but the guy was
scared.
The guy was scared, though.
I probably squatted about 400 pounds later that night.
And then you woke up.
But at the time, I was pretty angry, yes.
Mm-hmm. More angry than that one time you almost didn't bowl a 300?
Yes. I forgot to tell you guys this. That, at our August show with the Scott Hall show for Five Star, the last show we had, when I did the Irish whip reversal into the chairs, I wrecked into about a 300-pound woman that had nachos and cheese and spilled them all over my back. And that was one of my another indie wrestling promotion memories that I have.
Is that woman that you impregnated afterwards?
It could be.
Or was that that other
girl?
It's
one of
girl?
Like five, so I really don't know.
That, what's her name?
Your mom.
I'm sorry. So now you're going to talk about my mother.
I couldn't resist.
Ladies and gentlemen. My mother goes to the events. Ladies and gentlemen.
She's a great woman. I'm sorry.
Chest Flexor.
She wouldn't sleep with you.
Chest Flexor.
His mom just... Hold on. His mom just wrote a prayer. It is fantastic.
Chest Flexor. Yes, where can people follow up with you with their questions of indie wrestling and being a Chest Flexor on Twitter?
I am at Chest Flexor on Twitter. I am on Snapchat, Chest Flexor. I'm on YouTube at Chest Flexor. I am on Facebook, Chest Flexor, MySpace, Chest Flexor. I will give you Bryan's phone number where you could contact him messages to me. I won't give my phone number out, but once you're talking to Bryan, let me get that.
You need a buffer.
Yeah, obviously.
This
picture
like,
I showed
this
you,
like, this like fart noise, like gooey stuff.
Let me see that stuff. Can I see
this
that?
Is some pretty
just,
cool
just
stuff.
Just throw it at
you. You want to throw it at you? All
right. It landed right on my chair perfectly.
Did you make the noise, though? You need the container to make the noise.
I haven't figured it out.
Do you know how many viewers are on here right now?
I have no idea.
Okay.
I can probably find out if I can remember my password.
Seven viewers.
I was wondering. Just curious.
So this makes noises, apparently?
Apparently.
You got to stick it in the container. You need the container. It's a two-part toy. You need the container, and you need the
see how good this fart sounds.
I got a whole other batch over here.
Where's the container at?
Where can people find you on Twitter?
They can find me at Chest Flexor on Twitter, Chest Flexor on Snapchat, Chest Flexor on YouTube, Chest Flexor on Facebook, and MySpace, and I will give them Bryan's number to contact me.
That's right. Bryan McDowell, the bowler. The kingpin, if you will.
Lord of the Lanes.
Are you on the Twitter? Are you on the social media? Where can people hit you up for wrestling advice, bowling advice, or just dates?
I am Bryan McDowell on Facebook, and I am Bryan is Wrestling with a G on Twitter. I don't use it much, but if I get a bunch of emails saying I got more friends, I'm sure I'll go on it.
Everyone friend him!
Yes.
Everybody friend me.
Everybody friend me now. Snapchat. I am Bryan is Wrestling. I think no G on Snapchat. Is there a G on Snapchat?
I don't know.
Either a G or not a G on Snapchat. And that's all I have right now.
Lee Ryans.
You can find me at TheCockyD on Twitter. You can find me at Wild Child Lee Ryans on Facebook. And the Instagram account is also Wild Child Lee Ryans. Go in and give me a like because I'd really appreciate it.
You had a grinder, didn't you?
I had a grinder, but I deleted it when you friend requested me 500 times. Thank you.
Wait, What kind of Grindr?
Well, you know how you're on Tinder? He's on Grindr. It's like, I'll explain
it's
later.
For gay guys.
I'm no longer
Chest
on
Flexor.
Tinder.
Chest Flexor, no first longer. Question. Is there Grindr in the future?
What? Chest Flexor. Is there Grindr in the future, Chest Flexor?
Let me consult my futuristic friend. Corey, is there Grindr in the future?
Yes, there is. It's the number one app.
Well, thank you for telling me.
Core feature.
Sorg, there is Grindr in the future.
These guys.
So you'll be, whenever your wife divorces you, you will be in love.
Core futuristic, where are you on Twitter?
It's at futuristic Corey. I'm on Instagram under Corey Futuristic or Corey some color.
Are there pictures from the future?
I actually do like my Instagram. I'm pretty sweet.
Corey has an
Instagram.
Amazing Instagram.
Are there hoverboards that are actually hoverboards and not this bullshit two-wheeled crap that
There's hoverboards that they actually spew out nacho cheese when you're hungry. So
yes, everything that I hope.
Better than Michael J.
Thank
Fox
you.
Back to the Future.
Thank you so much. Corey Futuristic, what is the future of Sorgatron Media in the next 5 years?
To be the most awesome person alive, which you're already doing.
Fucking right. That's the right answer. Rizz!
Can I say I have Instagram too? I want everybody to Instagram.
Yes.
Rizz is here.
I'm here.
He does a rap every show, right? Come on, do a rap.
Do it.
Rap.
Do it.
Rap. Rap.
Let me drop the beat. Let me drop the beat.
Rap.
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 Rap. Rap. Rap. Rap. Rap.
Maybe if you get a beat. Maybe if you get a beat.
That's B-Rax's job.
I could beatbox.
I thought that's King Frank.
I can beatbox.
Not competing with B-Rax.
I am not competing with B-Rax. I am not competing with him.
Come on, dude. His name is Rizz, and he's here to say that just because you're on Grindr doesn't mean you're gay. All right, moving on. Eamon Paton, thank you so much. He is the voice of Inspire Pro Wrestling. Check it out, InspireProWrestling.com. Thank you to the sexy, talented dudes.
Thank
Flexor,
you. Thank
Bryan
you.
McDowell.
You're a fucking
Lee
gentleman.
Ryan.
I fucking love
Corey
you.
Corey Futuristic.
You just broke
the
his
Rizz
microphone.
Is joining us. Thank you so much. IndieWrestling.us. Support
like
Indie
and
Wrestling.
We're good to go.
Sing, sing, sing. You know how I act now. If you got a problem, come and see if I'm a back down. Wow. Steady sipping check now.
Show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at SorgatronMedia.com.